balls move a little bit. Okay? So, I'll walk around because this one's very kind of particular. You don't want to go right in the middle. Like, you don't want the balls to be together. They're separated a little bit. Okay? And they have to be in a certain spot where you actually, when you're tilting your pelvis forward and back, it's almost like it moves location. And if it doesn't, you can shift and shimmy down a little bit just to kind of get a little bit higher if that's the spot you need. But it's pretty individual to where you need it, right? Like maybe you're not even feeling this, maybe it doesn't matter. It's like, oh, I don't need it here. Are the balls about this far apart? So if you need a visual, and you can see this, it's just like this far, this much separated, and it's just kind of going up and down a little bit. Got it?
So without moving superior, inferior,
you're doing a pelvic tilt.
And then that'll slightly move it, and if it doesn't, then you can shift. But if you stick around after, I can show anyone that wants to stay a little bit later, I can show you the performance one, okay? So let's take the balls and bring them to the rhomboids. This is a really good one for the shoulder stuff and neck. So you're going to more through the middle to upper traps, kind of just above the shoulder blades there, like not high up on the neck, but and not super low down in between the shoulder blades, but right about there. And then you're going to, like you know in a little bridge pose, how you lift your hips up to go into a bridge pose, that'll be more of a pressure if you want it. If it feels like you're getting good stuff here just laying there, then just hang out. If not, press your feet in the ground and start to lift your hips, and the pressure will go back in towards the upper traps, and you'll feel it more, yeah?
Breathe through it. Let's see where you have yours.
I think they're 2.5.
Okay. I need to go. Okay. Let's just start. Unless you want, if you want one, okay. Then stay there.
It's my area.
Yeah. This is perfect for you then.
Facelift I was talking about. So basically you will have the foam roller
reverse it so all the fluid comes back down. So you gotta go back to the jaw. And I'll guide you through all this, I just wanted to show you. And then at the base of the skull under kind of under the ear. Okay? So that side and then the other side, and then we'll do the neck after, and it's just very gentle. And this is great for neck pain for most people. Okay, so let's start with the right side, and we'll kind of go into the right side of your body. You're perfect. You're already there.
And so you want to start just below the neck under the ear and doing very gentle little circles like massaging back there. Okay.
Jawline. along the back.